Now, in this video, I want to show you some ninja tricks that I use to make sure when I'm building a website using a page builder that I keep things consistent. And so what I'm gonna teach you how to do is make some design assets for your content pages. And so in this example, what we're going to do is we're going to create a page header that we're going to use on all of our pages. And then we're going to use this to save massive amounts of time so that we're not recreating everything on every page. So let me show you exactly what I mean. So here is our website so far. We built this in the last video. We built this beautiful website right here. Now, when I click on, say, this members dashboard page like that, this is how it looks, but I want to have a header that kind of matches our branding and has some text here and a subheadline right here. Now I'm going to show you how to do that and make sure it's identical in the style for all of the pages without us having to recreate it every single time. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So here I am on the home page that we created. Now we have this bar up here. We can actually get into Elementor at any time by clicking on this, or we can go the other way, which is to go to pages, and then we can find our page like this, home, and then we can click on this edit with Elementor button right here. So anyways, let's take a look at Elementor, and I'm sure as I show you what I'm talking about, it will make more sense to you. So I want to have a page header that's pre-designed and it's going to go on every page, and I want to use this font and probably this size of the font as well, and I want to keep this as well, but I want it to be using this background right here. Now, one of the beautiful power features of Elementor is they let you save things into a template library. So I can save this entire section right here into the template library, and I can easily use it on any single page. So what I like to do is before I start building out the additional pages on my site, I like to create what I kind of call a page asset template. And this is going to have my pre-styled buttons in it. And I might or might not use it on those other pages, but it's nice to have there so I don't have to restyle the button every time. And so I'm also going to use the headline in there so I don't have to redo that. And it's basically going to be a massive time saver. So first, let me show you how to do this. Now, I'm going to duplicate this entire section right here, and then I'm going to get rid of this content in there. So I'm going to click on section, and then I'm going to click on duplicate. And now when I scroll down, you can see I've duplicated that section perfectly. So right here, I'm going to go ahead and just try to clear this information out. So first, what I want to do is add a new column. So I'm going to go up to column right here and then click on the plus. All right, so I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to get rid of these two columns. So I'm going to go up to this column, I'm going to click on the X, and then delete that. And now I just have one column with my background that I want to use on all of those pages. So next, what I want to do is I want to use this headline. Actually, I want to use all of this. So I'm just going to duplicate each element and then drag it down. So I'm going to click on the duplicate button right here. And now I've got a duplicate, and I'm going to drag it and drop it down there. And then I want to do this one as well. I'm going to duplicate it, and I'm going to drag and drop that right there. And I'm not going to use the button on the page header, but it's nice to just have. So I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this button, and I'm going to drag and drop that down there as well. So I have this separate section right here. So now what I want to do is I want to click on section, and then I want to click this little save icon right here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and it's going to pull this up, and here it is. So I'm just going to call this my page assets, but you can name it whatever you want, whatever makes sense to you, or you can call it the content header, just whatever makes sense to you. So I'm going to go, so just go ahead and enter your name there and then click on the save button just like that. And so now I have those three templates we imported, and now we have this new section. It's a save section called page assets. Okay. So now to get out of this box, I'm going to go ahead and click on the X. Now I don't want to save any of this in Elementor, so I'm just going to click on this little X right here, and I'm going to click on go back to dashboard, and then it's going to give me this box here. Because you made some changes, it's saying, are you sure you want to leave? Because you're going to lose your changes. And I am sure. So I'm going to go ahead and click on leave. And now it's going to kick me back here. And you can see when I'm in the front end, I click on refresh, you're going to see that everything looks as it should right there. So now I've got that new design asset. So what I want to do is go into one of my content pages that you see here. So for instance, members dashboard. So I'm going to click into members dashboard. Now I haven't done anything to this page before. I've never done anything with Elementor on it. So remember, the first thing we need to do on a new page that we want to use Elementor is where it says template. We want to choose full width template like that. And then we want to click on the update button. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and click on edit with Elementor, and it's going to pop into a blank page right here in Elementor, just like that. So now what I want to do, instead of starting from scratch, I'm going to click on add template. And instead of these, obviously I'm not using one of these, I want to click on my templates right there. Here's my page asset. So I'm going to click on insert. And it's going to put that in there, that beautiful section that we created for the home page. But we're going to use this throughout the site as a page header. So first of all, I want to make this look really good on this page, and I think it's down too low. So right here, it's down too low. I want to lift it up some. So what we're going to do there is we're going to use something called negative margin. It's really simple. So I'm going to click on section, and our margin is, remember, it's right here in the advanced tab. And so here's our margin section. So I'm going to go ahead and unlink it just like that. And for the top, I'm going to put, let's see, a negative 40. So there we go. I did a negative 40, and what it did is it pulled it up closer to the header like that. Now, I think for a page header, this is a little too much space above here and below here. So what I'm going to do is, you see right here, I'm still in the advanced settings of the section. I have this padding that we were using when we did this on the home page. I think I want to remove it. 140 might be a little too much. Maybe I'm going to go down to 100. And that actually looks a little better, going down to 100 just like that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change this text a little bit. So I'm going to click on here where it says the most amazing course, and I'm going to change it. Okay, now I'm going to do the same for my subheadline right here. Probably you don't want two lines on a subheadline, so I'm going to make that one line. And there we go. So now this is looking pretty good to use across our website. So what you're going to do is we're going to add this to every single page that we create on this website. We're going to use this header. We're not going to use the button, obviously, in the header. The only reason I included the button is so that you could use it in other locations. If you're building out maybe a sales page or something like that, you don't have to recreate this button from scratch. But on the other page headers, we're not going to obviously have a button in there. So now that this is tweaked a little bit, I'm going to go ahead and delete the page template we made the first time and then resave it with all the adjustments that we just made. So I'm going to go ahead and click on add template. I'm going to go to my templates, and where it says page assets right here, let me just toss that name into the clipboard like this, and then I'm going to go ahead and delete it out. Okay, so now I deleted that page assets saved section. So let me close this. And now I'm going to save this section. I'm going to go to section, and then save just like that. And I'm going to just paste that name in. Of course, you can just retype the name of the page section if you want, if you didn't put it in your clipboard. And now I'm going to click on save. And there it is again with our modifications. So now let me get rid of this. So now we can add this to every single page that we're going to use on this website. So for this page right here, it's going to be the members dashboard. Now I would click on it and name it members dashboard, just like that. And then I'll put a subheadline in. Okay, I just put something corny in there. We just love our customers. Now on this page, I'm not going to use this right here, this button. So I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of that by clicking on the X, and now I've deleted out my button, and there's my beautiful page header that I'm going to use on my members dashboard. And you can obviously enter whatever you want here for the text. I'm going to go ahead and click on save. Now I'm not going to continue building this page until later when I build out all of the learning management pages, but I just wanted to show you how easy that is. So now let me get out of here. So hopefully you're following the strategy here of what I have taught. And that is essentially now we're going to be able to save a lot of time. So I've got this course page. I'm going to click on it like this. And then right here where it says template, I'm going to choose my full width template. I'm going to click on update. And now I'm going to click on edit with Elementor. And now the first thing I'm going to do is click on add template. I'm going to choose my templates and I'm going to insert the page assets. And on this page as well, I'm not going to use the button, so I can just go ahead and delete it. And then I can name this to the page title and my subheadline. And you saw how quick that was to, instead of reinventing the wheel every single time on every single page, you can pack in your design assets into one saved section that you can restore on each page, so you're not starting over from scratch. And that's the whole beauty behind Elementor and them giving this feature. That's the beauty of working smarter and also harder, well, working smarter and not harder, to build out a beautiful website that has consistency across the website. And that's what we're going after here, is page consistency. So the buttons look the same on every page. The headline looks the same on every page. The background looks the same on every page. However, you could easily change that background image if you wanted. There's so many options of what you can do here. And like I was explaining earlier, you can have a more masculine, conservative header if you wanted. You can make this look however you want, but this is how you're going to save a ton of time building out your website, by making these design asset pages.